So today I'm going to talk about control. Answering the question, who is controlling your life? Okay, so first and foremost, I would say God should be in control of your life. Seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness and everything will be added unto you. So God is in control of your life. Everyone would say that. That's an obvious answer that everyone would say, even though God is not in control of their lives. But so just make sure that God is in control of your life. But then now let's talk about people. Who is in control of your life? Like other human beings. Who controls your life? And whoever it is that controls your life, you need to, how can I put it? You just need to undo the whole thing. Okay, you need to find ways of how you can undo that control. Being controlled comes in different forms. The easiest way that other people get to control your life is through resources. If they have resources that you need, then they begin to control your life. An example, a married woman who is not working. All her economic needs are dependent on her husband. So that husband would then control that woman. That's why Mina, as a success coach, I always tell women, I don't say get a job. I say start your business. Find your passion, have a vision, and then start your business. Then you have economic independence. You have economic empowerment. Then nobody controls your life. And then control can also come from relatives. Yeah, relatives can want to control your life. You can be a grown woman, maybe 30, 40, 50, and then you still find that your mother and father, like your birth mother and father, are still controlling you. But what weapons do they use to control you? Sometimes it can be economic empowerment because you're like 40 years old and you don't have a job. You still ask for money from your mother and your father, so they will control you. So you have to get out of that and get a job or start a business. Become independent. I mean, just become responsible. On this one, I would just say become responsible. And then the next, even your brothers and sisters can control you. But most controls come from the person that is controlling you has got resources. And you depend on that person for resources. So the way out is that you should get your own resources. Then you don't get controlled or go and control other people. But that's not good. Just don't do it. Just don't do it. Just don't do it. Okay, another way that people would use to control you is through fear. They would threaten you that if you do not do as they say, bad things will happen to you. This is mostly found in churches, especially our modern day churches. You'll find that probably the men of God will threaten you that if you do not sow a seed, bad things are going to happen to you. If you do not tithe, bad things are going to happen to you. If you do not do this, that, through threats. And because you are afraid, you then have to do everything that they tell you to do. So that's another form of control. So how do you get out of that form of control? From like being controlled by a church, by a man of God. You just have to read the Bible yourself and take control away from the man of God and take it to Christ and then be controlled by Christ. Christ is good. God is good. God loves you. God will not threaten you, right? So that's the way. The thing is that you should just be an independent person and an independent thinker. You just have to decide how much money do you want to take to church, how much money do you want to sow. Don't be coerced, right? Don't be coerced. Just become an independent person. So that's another form of control. Okay, another form of control is being controlled by the government. Yeah, well, that control, you actually have no control over it. You have no power over what the government says you should do. I mean, we're in the middle of lockdown times, and you know you're told, stay at home. Sometimes with no food, like in Zimbabwe, for instance, there are no stimulus packages. If you stay at home, you'll starve at home, okay? So that's another control. That's another form of control when the government controls you and tells you to stay at home for your own safety. Because there is a disease on the loose. But hunger probably is also another thing. But anyway, that's my own opinion about stuff. But you have no control. You have to stay at home. If you go out, you get arrested. Okay? So you just have now to find a way around it. So government control. Let's say lockdown. You are locked down. You are told, stay at home. You are into catering. Let's say like myself, I have a catering business in the lodge, a guest house. So if I'm told to stay at home, that means all of us always stay at home. There's no one to cook for. There's nothing happening at the lodge. So what you do is that you start working online. That's how I started success coaching. because I was locked up during the first lockdown. I was locked up, and then I thought, what can I do online? But I want to do something interesting, something that I would enjoy. I thought of typing online, teaching English online. But then I thought, that's a job. I don't have a job. I'm an entrepreneur. So that's when I started online coaching. So I went on and opened my website, www.successtalkwithnoma.com. And then I started coaching people online. And the response has been good. Success Talk with Noma is like a year old, but the response is good. Organizations call me, and I get to coach online on Zoom. I get to speak like motivational speaking, teaching people about vision and purpose online. And sometimes I do it even on WhatsApp, because here in Zimbabwe there are some people who don't have access to Zoom. Their phones cannot actually download a lot of packages, but what they have is WhatsApp. So I have coached on WhatsApp several times, and that is an income that will come to you while you're just sitting at home locked down. So when you're being controlled and there is no way out for you, what you must do then is to find a way to live within what the government has said you should do, because the government is the government. Breaking the laws of the government will get you arrested. Okay, yeah. So those are the forms of control that I thought I would discuss, and then I'll just leave you with this. Just economic empowerment is the way out of a lot of things, even government control. Have you noticed that, when we're on lockdown, the borders are closed and everything, but the airways are opened? People want to fly, can fly wherever they want to go. That is, people with money can fly to South Africa whenever they want. But you, who's waiting for the border to open? Why are you waiting for the border to open? Because you are not economically empowered. You don't have enough money. So remember, economic empowerment. Have a vision, find your purpose in life, start a business. And then you'll see that even if people try to control you, it will be very minimal, minimal. Economic empowerment. Happy Women's Month. Women, get yourself, deliver yourself from the clutches of control from everyone around you. God controls you. Live with that. That's good. That's perfect, because God is your creator. And when he's controlling you, your life is good. You're in a good space. But when other humans try to control you, you are in a bad space. You are in a bad space. Get out of it. And economic empowerment is the best way out. So goodbye, and God bless for today. From me, Noma Langancube, from Success Talk with Noma. Cheers, and God bless.